What's up, Netwalkers? It's Will from TVC, and I got another video for you guys today. I'm going over the AB night vision, articulating RNVG. Before I start the video, like in all my other videos, I like to give a full disclosure and let the viewers know that I work at TVC, and that's how I get access to these products that I review. Not all the time, but many of the products these days that I'm showing, it's because I get access to them from being at TVC. It's the same case with this device right here. Just know that this channel is not part of what my job at TVC. It's something I do on the side. Whenever I get products that I think are pretty cool, I like to go into some more detail on them on this channel, and that's what I'm doing right here for you guys today. All right, what is the articulating RNVG? I'll just give you a little quick history lesson for anybody who's not familiar with it. So the RNVG, the name right there, stands for Ruggedized Night Vision Goggle, and it references a goggle that AB Night Vision made some years back. It's really earned a name for itself in the industry and in the night vision market as being a bomb-proof system, just a super tough goggle. And the reason for that is because the whole thing is made out of 7075 aluminum. Now the RNVG, it's what's called a fixed bridge goggle. I don't have one here to show you, but I have a TNVC Artemis. This is the BNVG binocular night vision goggle, and it's a similar design to the RNVG in terms of it's a fixed bridge goggle. And what that means by fixed bridge is that the bridge is fixed in place. The pods are attached to the bridge. They're fixed in place on the bridge. Now they do move left to right. You just turn these knobs right here, and that's how you adjust the pods left to right for your eye spacing. However, that's the only movement that these pods do. And so what the articulating RNVG does is this thing, hence the name, it articulates. The pods are attached on this hinge right here to the bridge. Like I said, it's all 7075 aluminum. Super tough, but it articulates. This is a pretty useful feature. A lot of people really like articulation. Myself, I actually prefer a fixed bridge goggle myself, but I do like these. I do recognize most people out in the market, they really want an articulating system. And the reason for that is you can have both eyes under night vision. You could flip up one, just have one eye under night vision. One cool feature to the articulating RNVG, and this is something to know, so this thing is out there. You'll see it as the ARNVG, stands for articulating RNVG. Here at TNVC, we like to follow the RNVG nomenclature, so we're gonna be calling it the RNVG-A. It's not up on the website as of today. We'll be going up there pretty soon. So if you want to find it, you can look under night vision goggles or night vision binoculars in the menu, or just do a search for RNVG-A and then you'll find it. So anyways, so this thing articulates, the pods turn off. So you got this little magnet right here. That's what this thing is, right in that spot right there. And when you articulate it up, it's going to kill power to the tube or the pod right here. This shuts off, this one remains on. This is like a tactical power turn off, I guess, feature you'd call it. And that just minimizes any light splashing back on your helmet if you got it flipped up like that, as well as conserves power because this one's not using any power. And then if you flip them both up, they're both gonna turn off. As soon as you bring them back down, they turn back on automatically. It's a pretty cool feature the way they have that with the magnets in there. So that's the main benefit to an articulating goggle is the fact that you can use one eye at a time, or both eyes at a time, or flip them both up like this, and they're both out of the way. You don't have to stow the goggle up on your helmet to get them off of there. And then when you do stow them up on the helmet, by laying them back like this on the helmet, it helps to lower the weight distribution back on the helmet versus traditional goggles, like a fixed bridge. When you have them like this and you flip them up, they're gonna be sticking out there a little bit. I'll give you a quick demonstration with this helmet to kind of show you guys what it looks like. So there's a Wilcox G24 dovetail mount. Pop this bad boy in there, just like that. And so this is what I'm talking about right here. So you articulate him up, you can get him out of the way without having to flip it up on your helmet. Now when you do flip it up on your helmet and you lay him back flat like this, it lowers the weight down, makes it more comfortable. If you didn't articulate like that, it'd be sticking out there more. You could definitely feel the weight when it's like that. And bringing it back like this does make it pretty handy for you. So the articulating feature, really useful, for using one eye. You could use your unaided eye to read ambient lighting conditions, because sometimes you got both eyes under night vision especially for inexperienced users, people that don't use night vision a lot, it can be tough to read what the ambient lighting conditions are, which can be important. Obviously, even though you got night vision, you can see in the dark, you still got to maintain, basic common sense, stay in the shadows, things like that. Don't be out where you're, spotlighting yourself under the moon or a street light or whatnot. As well as when you articulate it up, this does give you the ability to now use a thermal scanner, maybe a thermal scope, something like that as well. On the front here, you got two buttons. The lower one is the power button. The top one is your IR illuminator button. This has a fence around it to prevent it from accidental activation. And then this little black circle right there is your IR emitter for the illuminator. Now the power button, it does have, and both of them have distinctive clicks. Let me see if you can hear it. So you could definitely, you know, feel it and hear it when you click it. However, there's no visual indication if it's on or off. Now on the back of it, you've got the rear mounted battery compartment. It's mounted underneath the bridge. And this battery cap, you know, it's pointed towards your forehead. So to do battery changes on the fly, best bet is just move it up on your mount, unscrew it, drop the battery out, put the new one in. Now the battery pack port, you know, for remote mounted remote battery pack. And this is a LiMo connector, by the way. Best battery pack to run with it. Just cover that real quick. It's also made by AB Night Vision. It's called the Low Profile Battery Pack. It's inside this Mark II Mohawk. I'm not going to pull it out here for you, but it's a great battery pack. Best one to use with it. Reason for that is that the cable is long enough to reach all the way to the front of the goggle with extra room left over. That's really important so you have enough strain relief so you're not damaging the cable or the connector, as well as you just want that longer cable. It's designed for it. It's a great battery pack because you can run two AA's on each side. There's two compartments, or a single 123 in each compartment, so two 123s. That's my preference with it because it runs a 123 inside of it as well, but hey, if you like AA's, you could do that inside the battery pack. This thing also has the ability to select which side that you're running power off of, as well as to turn it off so you got no power going to the goggle itself, which is a nice feature. So if you're not running a battery inside the device, once you disconnect the power to the goggle itself, you're less concerned about accidentally, you know, turning it on if you don't mean to. But having the redundant power supply, it's a great feature. You get the most runtime that way, obviously. With it, something to know is that this battery pack connector, it is pretty close to the battery cap, as you can see. And once you got it plugged in, it is gonna take up some extra space right here. So you just have to do some practice with it, with manipulation to get this battery cap off. Especially at dark, you know, when it's dark out, if you're doing battery swaps at night under nods, I would do plenty of practice with it and just get familiar with the intricacies of that. The dovetail location, it's up here, just one spot. There's no additional mounting holes for it. As you can see, it's pretty far forward on the goggle, which isn't terrible. However, it does mean that you know, for some folks, you're gonna have to run your mount pretty far out sometimes to clear iPro with these. Just depends on your helmet size, your type of helmet, iPro, things like that. Just keep that in mind. The best helmet mount that I recommend to use with it because of that is gonna be a new production G24. Because they have this extended travel distance on the arm. So you got plenty of space to run this thing out. If you're running like an older style G24 that didn't have the longer travel on it, or something like this Nerotos Losto, you're only going to be able to get it out so far. So I'll just kind of show you real quick on the helmet. Let me pull up this camera a little bit, give you some height here. And so here's the Losto. This is like a 1.1 inch travel. I already have it run all the way out. And plugged in, you can see it's, you know, it's fairly close to the helmet into your eyes. A lot of people like to run their goggles right up on their eyeballs. I'm not really big on that. I like to have a little bit of standoff, and that way I can see around the pods a lot better, as well as I'm not going to scratch up my iPro or my glasses if this thing starts moving or something like that, or my glasses come forward. And so I'll show you how it is with the G24. You can definitely have more travel with that longer arm on it. And so right here, I plug it in, that's that position, but you can see how much more far forward you can get it. And so I would say with this particular goggle, due to the dovetail location, I would go with the G24 mount. Like I said, a new production that has the 1.4 inch travel. It's really obvious just because the normal position for these things, you'll have some leftover right there. You know, so anyways, if you're not sure, you know, you just get a hold of us at TVC and we only carry the new ones. And if you have any questions about them, we have low stows as well. G24s are kind of hard to get. Low stow mounts are fantastic as well. They just don't have as much travel for this goggle. So if you're really big about wearing iPro, I'd maybe consider, you know, just doing the G24 or just planning for that G24. Now with this particular RNVG-A, I'm sure plenty of you folks have already noticed this, but these are running RPO lenses with TNVC custom diopters on them. And so if you're not familiar with what RPO is, it's a company called Rochester Precision Optics. They make lightweight optics. They've been going on into night vision goggles for a while now. TVC, we've had the RPO 2.0s for a while. We've been doing upgrades for people. Just haven't had it up on the website. We started adding them onto the website now to where if you're buying a new goggle from us, a TVC built system, that is, the L3 finish systems, those, we're not swapping optics on those. I'm sure we probably could on a 1531, but at that point, just get a 31A. But anyways, back to this thing. So anyways, that option's there. It's going to be there on the RNVG-A once the listing goes up. Otherwise, if you don't choose the Rochester Precision Optics lenses, you're going to get the standard PVS 14 lenses. At TVC, we only use Carson lenses. These are mil-spec lenses, excellent quality, great, mil-spec lenses. You can't go wrong with those at all. Plenty of eye relief on them as well. But they are glass-based, and so they're going to be a heavier type of lens, which isn't terrible. I mean, this RNVG-A with Carson lenses on it, it's about 20 and a half ounces without the battery. So call it 21 ounces with the battery. Batteries are about half an ounce. This particular goggle, I don't have the battery in it. Let me show you how much this thing weighs. And so it's pretty slick. Let me get this thing turned on here. All right, so 16.4 ounces. I mean, that's pretty awesome for a 70/75 aluminum goggle with lenses fully kitted out, ready to rock. Minus the battery, under 17, just at 17, I guess, just under 17 with the battery in it. And that's a pretty significant weight savings. In my opinion, that's the main reason to go with these RPO lenses, is for that weight savings. There's a lot of stuff out there. I'm not going to get into it for the lenses. I do like the RPOs in terms of the weight savings, in terms of the performance of the lenses. I personally, don't see a difference myself, to really justify the extra cost in terms of the lens doing anything for you compared to Carson lenses. But when it comes to the weight, that's where I see a significant improvement. If you want a system that's gonna be as light as possible, go with these. And then these diopters, pretty cool. These are a custom TVC diopter. You can see the TVC Raven logo inside of them. Pretty slick feature there. And something else to note on this one, obviously this is black, but the RNVG-A is gonna be available in an FDE finish as well. And that's going to be similar to this color right here on the bridge. Well, this has a wrap on it, but it's going to be that kind of a tan color. You can kind of see it in there. And that's how it's going to look. So you can get it both ways, FDE or black. FDE is going to be a little bit more money because of that Cerakote finish. Now, when it comes to attaching a lanyard system to your RNVG-A, currently the way it's designed is that you have these lanyard loops that are part of the pod casting right here. And so these aren't ideal. I don't like them there. The reason why is on an articulating goggle, let's say, a lot of times I don't necessarily mess with articulation, even if I have it. If I just want to get my nods, if I want my eyeballs both to be under eyeballs and not nods, it's faster for me just to push the button on the mount and flip them up. So if I do that and I have proper tension on these, it's going to want to spread them apart like that, which means now I can't just quickly come back down. So I don't really like them there. So what I did is I just took some zip ties, put them around this part of the bridge right here, and I attach them that way. I use OpScore helmets, and so I use these MBS shrouds. They've got the bungee as part of the shroud. It just goes directly down to these zip ties, and that's my preference on how to do a lanyard. You could also, if you get a kinetic consulting nerd, attaches the Velcro to the helmet. You just do a simple cow hitch or girth hitch around the bridge itself, and then you can kind of accomplish the same thing there with the nerd. To wrap up the video, I'll tell you that I really, really do like this housing quite a bit. And what I like about it is that it's all 70/75 aluminum, so it's super tough. It definitely earns that RNVG designation, the ruggedized night vision goggle, being all made of aluminum like that. And then it comes with this remote battery pack port that's integrated into it. So you don't have to buy an adapter, if you want to run a remote battery pack, which that's the preferred way to do it, in my opinion, on a system. So you have redundant power supplies. And then also with this housing, if you add the RPO lenses, it has reduces the weight tremendously, and it just becomes a super tough and lightweight goggle that works great. Now I do want to cover some stuff on the system, and I don't want these to come across as like huge negatives on it, but these are things that people should know if you're going to buy it. Not major deal breakers, nothing like that, but just things you should know. So the first thing is going to be the power button. So because the power button is a push button and it's non-protected, you do have the possibility, because it just takes a single press. It's not like a press and hold like other goggles. So it does have more ability to be accidentally turned on. So what I tell you, a couple things that I do with this goggle, since I've been using it, is Yeah, I keep it articulated out when it's stowed on the helmet, and that way I know it's turned off all the time. You know, same thing, like if you're gonna be having it down, I find it pretty comfortable just to keep it in the deployed position and articulated versus stowing it. But if you do stow it and you keep it this way, you know it's gonna be turned off, it's gonna stay off. Just something to know is that if you do accidentally push the button, you're gonna turn it on. Even though these pods aren't gonna be turned on when they're articulated, when you bring them back together, they will turn back on again. So anytime you have them in this position, I would just do a visual confirmation, make sure they're turned off. And then the other thing that I would do, so with all the TNVC systems, we include these bikini covers with them. And so a lot of guys don't run them. They actually don't know about these things, like how they should use them. I don't have the retainers here to show you, but it comes with these retainers that you go on the front and the back that keep the bikinis on here. So when you flip it off, you're not gonna lose it. It's just gonna hang on it. Sometimes those break. You'll see guys using Ranger bands and things like that to hold them on there. So anyways, what I would do is anytime you're gonna be using this thing and you're not gonna be using it for a minute, you're gonna have it stowed up on your helmet, put the front bikini cover on at the minimum. The rear is not so much of an issue. This is just more for lens protection. But on the front, and don't punch a hole in it, don't try to turn it into a lens refocus device. Keep it solid, because with a solid cover on it, there's no light coming into it. So if you do accidentally turn it on or you have it turned on, there's no ability for light damage to occur because there's no light entering the system. So that's your extra safety backup that I would do on that. And then the other things to talk about is the, obviously with the battery or the dovetail location, like I talked about, you definitely want to run a Wilcox G24 mount that has a new production one that has the extended travel on it. And so that way you can push it all the way out if you need to. Just know that Wilcox G24s right now have a pretty long backorder time. Wilcox is working their ass off to get caught up on that. So hopefully that'll change soon, but just know that there's a backorder time on those right now. But that would be my preferred mount to run with this goggle. And then the last thing, second to last, you know, lanyard loop locations, not a big fan of those. Not a huge deal to just run the zip ties or something else, or just get a kinetic consulting nerd to run on it and then to get your lanyard situation all taken care of. And then the last thing to talk about are these hinges. And so on the hinges, as you see, it's a little catchy. I'm not doing that on purpose. It just kind of catches a little bit. It's not super smooth. Not a huge deal. That doesn't really bother me that much. But I see guys messing with the screw and trying to loosen it up and find a smoother action on it or whatever. And if you do that, you introduce the possibility of this nut on the back backing out. So if this nut gets loose and then you're doing this a whole bunch, you have the potential to walk this nut off of the screw and then lose the nut. And it'll still stay on there, you know, just based on the design. As you can see, it's not going to come out. But you're going to want to get another nut, you know, obviously just don't want to be running it like that. So anyways, just keep that in mind with it. If you play with the screws, I'd just keep an eye on that nut. I'd keep an eye on the nut anyways, just to be safe. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know I don't upload content a lot, so I do appreciate when you guys watch my videos when I put them up. It does mean a lot to me. If you guys have any questions, comments, put them down below on the video, or you can just reach out to me at TNVC as well. My name is Will, like I said at the beginning, and I appreciate you guys watching the video. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and you guys take care.